Is Pluto a planet? It's been one of astronomy's most controversial questions since a meeting of the International Astronomical Union (IAU) in August 2006 voted to downgrade the then ninth planet to mere dwarf planet status. Not only is the IAU's definition of a planet 15 years ago roundly ignored by planetary scientists, but the IAU's use of a vote made science seem arbitrary and political, undermining trust in science itself. So says Dr. Alan Stern, a planetary scientist who leads NASA's New Horizons mission that explored the Pluto system in 2015. He was speaking at the I Heart Pluto Festival 2021, a virtual program of lectures and events staged by Lowell Observatory in Flagstaff, Arizona, the very site of Pluto's discovery on February 18, 1930 by astronomer Clyde Tombaugh. Stern's argument against the decision to relate Pluto to dwarf planet status boils down to this: it doesn't make scientific sense. The IAU relegated Pluto after a flurry of new discoveries of small planets in the outer solar system, notably Eris in 2005, so the IAU felt that it had to create a tighter, more exclusive definition of a planet. Pluto doesn't get tick that last box because it's influenced by Neptune's gravity. It also shares its orbit with other objects in the Kuiper Belt. So Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet to sit alongside Eris, Ceres, Haumea and Makemake. Stern thinks that definition of a planet is poorly worded. The IAU's definition was created by non-experts, astronomers, who study stars, galaxies and black holes, he said. They botched it. He thinks the IAU overacted because they were horrified by the idea that there could be hundreds of small planets beyond the orbit of Neptune in the Kuiper Belt. The purpose of the IAU in creating this definition was to limit the number of planets in our solar system so that school kids wouldn't have to memorize long lists of planets, he said. Astronomers became afraid of astronomically large numbers. That's a shame because one of the revolutions in planetary science in the last 40 years has been the discovery that the Kuiper Belt, that third zone in the solar system beyond the orbit of Neptune, is busy with comets, planetesimals and small planets like Pluto. They now outnumber the terrestrial and gas planets and are expected to number in the hundreds when surveys are complete, said Stern. He also makes the point that the solar system is littered with asteroids to the extent that no celestial body has cleared the neighborhood around its orbit. It's why planetary researchers ignore the IAU's definition of a planet in favor of a geophysical definition that's completely agnostic to the total number of planets in the solar system. That way, Stern says, Pluto easily qualifies as a planet, as do all dwarf planets. However, Stern also accused the IAU of harming science itself when it publicly voted to relegate Pluto in 2006. Voting is a terrible mechanism of doing science, he said.